Man, a pleasant good afternoon to you. Welcome aboard. It's Pastor Karen here on Bahama UK Radio, exclusively on the Saturday Gospel Hour. Today is Saturday, 16th of September 2023, in the year of our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ. Wherever you are, strategic among the continents of the world, I greet you in the name of our triune God. Our listeners in the United Kingdom, the Bahamas, the Americas, and across planet Earth, I also greet you in the name of our triune God. My listener, trust you're having a beautiful Saturday. Amen. We've crossed over from the earthly and the profane, and we're in the presence of Jehovah the Most High God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, with myriads and myriads and myriads and myriads and myriads of angels who are all on assignment. This is a holy, sacred, and divine time. I say to you, my listener, prepare your heart to receive all that glory has foreordained for you this afternoon. Amen. The Father is at work, the Son is at work, the Holy Spirit is at work, myriads and myriads and myriads and myriads of angels are all at work. What a mighty God we serve. Amen. Father, we welcome you. Jesus, we welcome you. Holy Spirit, we welcome you. And all the angels, you are most welcome in Jesus' name. Amen. Radio Land, I kindly ask if you can share the broadcast for the propagation of God's gospel around planet Earth in the mighty name of Jesus, that God's kingdom will multiply, will increase, will expand, will proliferate, will populate, and will spread in the mighty name of Jesus. Radio Land, I thank you in advance for your sharing. Amen. Radio Land, Pastor Terence will bless us all in prayer. Amen. God richly bless you, Pastor Terence, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Worship you, Lord, in the mighty name. mighty name of Jesus Christ. As I come, O Lord, as I come in the name of Jesus, I present end time prevailing men and women. I present them before you, Lord God. I plead every cause in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your righteous will be done in each of their lives, O God. Father God, I pray for courage. Give strength to those that are weak, Lord. Give them power, Lord God, to lift up your name. Power to call on you, O Almighty God. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Yes, Lord. I pray for their homes, their family, O Lord God, their children, all their neighbors and friends, mighty God. O Lord, I bring them before you, Lord, yet another time, knowing that you know all things. Just have your way in their life, O God. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I pray that as they go forward in your name, in the name of Jesus, Father God, that you will be with them, O Lord, in the person of your Holy Spirit. I pray, O Lord God, that every rough road may be smooth and every hills may be made low and every valley will be filled. And every crooked path will be straight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Help us, O Lord, that as we call upon your name, we will receive answers as we cry, Abba Father. Lord, help us this day. Lead us and guide us. Direct our path. Bless us, I pray. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. God richly bless you, Pastor Terence, in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father, we thank you that you are the Most High God who hears and answers prayers always, in Jesus' name. Amen. If you've just tuned in, you tuned in live to the Saturday Gospel Hour here on Bahama UK Radio, The Bridge, from the United Kingdom to the Bahamas and the wider communities of the world. Amen.
How could you?
Amen. Mighty God be praised. Amen. Our sermon on this blessed Saturday is titled, and it's the conclusion of a friendship that lies beyond the ages. A friendship that lies beyond the ages. And it's the same text, the Synoptic Gospel of John, the 15th chapter, reading from the 12th verse through the 15th verse. My command is this, love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. Mighty God be praised. The word of the Lord is indeed blessed. Amen. Radio Land, do let us pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Eternal, sovereign, and course unsurpassed, the most holy, sacrosanct, and the only potentate ruler over all creation and mankind. Heavenly Father, your Son, Christ Jesus, called his disciples friends. Amen. May your Holy Spirit grant us a greater understanding of this friendship that have been demonstrated by Jesus Christ. Amen. Soften the heart of the listener, that your word will be an enormous blessing and comfort to their life, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The Most High God, the great hearer of prayer, the Most High God, the great answerer to prayer, thank you for answered prayers, in Jesus' name. Amen. A friend that lies beyond the ages. Conclusion. My listener, in the theology of the Bible, Jesus called his disciples, who were his servants, friends. Jesus, the co-equal and the second of the Trinity and the second of the Godhead, understood the importance of friendship. Just as his father did when he called Abraham his friend in James, the second chapter, in the 23rd verse. And this scripture was fulfilled that says, Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness, and he was called God's friend. Amen. As pilgrims passing through this world, we are traveling by faith in Jehovah the Most High God. Remember, the Hebrew writer says that faith is a substance of things hoped for, in chapter 11, verse 1. The evidence of things not seen. By faith, the patriarchs, what happened? They retained a favorable report. Amen. A good report. Amen. So no matter the perils, innumerable trials and triumphs, one of the most valuable blessings God grants to us is the gift of friends, amen, who share our faith. These friends are not entirely consorts for our secular journey, but are necessary for our spiritual advancement and welfare, amen. When we were to look at Proverbs, the 17th chapter and the 17th verse, it expresses, a friend loves at all times. A true friend will not only love when it is easy, But at all times, what used to be called fair weather friends, those are friends only when the weather is pleasant and fair. Sadly, they are not true friends at all. Only when things are going well for you, they are your friend. And immediately, you experience ramifications in your life. What do? They turn their back on you. And perhaps it could be for something as perhaps you got ill, or you lost your job, or you have family problems or financial problems. It could just be any situation that has put you at a disadvantage. You will see the back of your supposedly friend, my Lord. How sad. But this has happened to many of us. And still happens. It's still happening. Radio Land, check it out. Remember in scripture, Ahithophel. Ahithophel, what did he do? He deserted King David. King David experienced the pain of betrayal by a friend. What did he write in the 41st chapter in the 9th verse? Even my own familiar friend in whom I trusted, who ate my bread, he lifted up his heel against me, my Lord. Jesus was betrayed by Judas. Judas sold our Lord. What does Apostle John write in the 13th chapter and the 18th verse? I do not speak concerning all of you. I know whom I have chosen, but that the scripture may be fulfilled, he who eats bread with me has lifted up his heel against me, my Lord. You hear the echo of the psalmist David that I've read to you from the 41st chapter and the 9th verse, my Lord. The greatest and honorable of kings who have been fawned upon by their courtiers, while in power, have been treated as if they were dogs. In the time of their extremity, in the time when they faced great challenges, when they faced great problems, they were betrayed. My Lord. My Lord. One theologian, what does he say concerning a renowned and succinct man of God? What happened to this man of God? When he was at his last, when all of his congregation betrayed him, imagine, he pastored a congregation for more than 2 decades, and his congregants, they all turned against him because of standing on the adulterated word of God. And what did the man of God do? He cried out, "Where is Jesus of Nazareth, my old and faithful friend?" Hallelujah. I know he will be with me now that I need his help. And so he was. Jesus was with him. For this faithful pastor, this faithful servant of Jesus died a triumphant death. Mighty God be praised. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, hallelujah, mighty God be praised. All believers in Christ Jesus, it is important to understand our friendships are found through faith, and our friendships can be strengthened. It can strengthen our walk with God. Amen. When our friendships are built upon faith, we are likely to discover people who share our beliefs, who share our values and moral compass. Amen. This order strengthens us to encourage each other in the faith. Seek Jehovah's guidance and pray together. Genuine friends in faith help us advance together, stronger in God. Hallelujah. May our friends be of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you for granting us godly friends in the mighty name of Jesus. Friends that know you, friends that understand you, friends that have a relationship with you in the mighty name of Jesus. As your word says, do not be unequally yoked in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank you that our friendships are from you in the mighty name of Jesus, that our friendships are divine in the mighty name of Jesus. Our friendship will bring out the best version of ourselves in the mighty name of Jesus. Mighty God be praised. Radio Land, as believers of Christ Jesus, those who are believers of Christ Jesus, remember you are God's holy priesthood, his royal nation, his holy diadem. You are his remnant. You are his covenant child. Hallelujah. Mighty God be praised. When you are choosing friends, like I said last week, I have learned, Radio Land, everyone that will come into my life, I petition them to the throne room of grace. Why? Because I don't want to go ahead of God and I don't want to get it wrong. Why? Because my life is not my own. In life, I am not my own. In death, I am not my own, Radio Land. And this experience has come with time, Radio Land. I was not always in this position. I did not always have access to this knowledge. I grew into this, Radio Land, through the power of our triune God. I trust it will be the same for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. My listener in Radio Land, God is a covenant-keeping God. Hallelujah. His word remains true in the mighty name of Jesus. Remember the narrative of David and Jonathan. Mighty God be praised. Let's look at 1 Samuel, the 18th chapter, and the first verse. And it promulgates, and it came to pass, when he made an end of speaking unto Saul, that the soul of Jonathan was knit with the soul of David, and Jonathan loved him as his own soul. Oh, mighty God be praised. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, mighty God be praised. Amen. Radio Land, when David had finished conversing with King Saul regarding the killing of Goliath, his fame in Israel was assured. He executed an outstandingly heroic act and was initially welcomed by the leadership of Israel. Jonathan was a brave man of faith who initiated a one-man war against the Philistines. Jonathan was a lot like David. They were in the same age group. Jonathan was at least 5 years older. They were both bold. Both men had great trust in Jehovah the Most High God, and both of them were men of action. Most importantly, both men had a genuine relationship with God. Amen. At the same time, Jonathan and David had different backgrounds. Jonathan was the firstborn son of King Saul, and David was the lastborn son of Jesse, a farmer. Jonathan was a crown prince. By everyone's expectation, Jonathan would be the next king of Israel. The soul of Jonathan was knit to the soul of David. This happened after David had finished speaking to Saul. Jonathan heard David gave an extended explanation of his heart, his faith in the living God. And Jonathan knew that he and David had the same heart. Amen. Many people would say that Jonathan was the one who had the most to fear from David's success. Yet he loved David because what they had in common was a genuine, authentic relationship with God, which was larger than any difference. Amen. Then Jonathan and David, what did they do? They made a covenant. Two men, each on track for the same throne, yet they made a covenant of friendship that would prove stronger than jealousy, that would prove stronger than envy, that would prove stronger than ambition, and that would prove stronger than power. Mighty God be praised. Hallelujah. Scripture goes on to express that Jonathan took off the robe that was on him and gave it to David with his armor, even to his sword and his bow and his belt. When Jonathan gave David the robe and his armor, he said by this action to imply, you will be the next king of Israel. You should be dressed and armored as the crown prince. Mighty God be praised. God's hand is on you. And these rightfully belong to you. Amen. Because Jonathan was totally surrendered to God, he could see the hand of the Lord upon David. Amen. Hallelujah. Mighty God be praised. David's desiring and was perfectly willing to set aside his ambition to honor the Lord's choice. Amen. If Jonathan was ready to recognize David as God's choice for the next king, David was willing to let God put him on the throne and to do it in God's timing. Both of these men were thoroughly submitted to the Lord. Amen. Radio Land, what is so admirable about Jonathan and David? They both loved God and lived more for him and for others than for themselves. David and Jonathan both knew that If the circumstances were reversed, David would do the exact same thing for Jonathan because they had the same soul. Hallelujah. They loved each other more than the throne of Israel because they loved the Lord more than the throne of Israel. Hallelujah. They were not competitive. They weren't competing. Oh, glory be to God on high. Hallelujah. Mighty God be praised. They were not competing with each other. Hallelujah. They belong to the same kingdom. Mighty God be praised. The kingdom of Jehovah the Most High God. Hallelujah. Therefore, they wished each other well in the mighty name of Jesus. They brought out the best in each other. Hallelujah. May you bring out the best of your friend. May your friend bring out the best of you in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. My listener, there is an idiom. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree, meaning a child usually has a similar character or qualities to their parents. The son may also be called a chip of the old block. The history of Saul and David, one cannot relate to Jonathan in such a fashion. In contrast to Saul's selfishness, madness, and fear, Jonathan projects bravery, wisdom, and selflessness. Amen. When King Saul wanted to exterminate David, Jonathan opposed him and dissuaded him of his plans. Sadly, King Saul had not changed his mind and was still after David's demise. When Jonathan learnt of his father's actions toward David, Jonathan fell into disbelief. However, David knew better, and he urged Jonathan to inquire why Saul sought after his life. Jonathan and David, they made a covenant of friendship that would prove stronger, like I said earlier, than anything Radioland. Hallelujah. The covenant promise of Jonathan and David, what did it do? It assured David that he was telling the truth and had no designs on the throne that God would give to David someday after Saul. When we were to look at the history of the ancient Near East, when a new king came to power, he would exterminate the entire family of the preceding monarch in order to get rid of anyone who might be a threat to his throne or to his rule. David's covenant promise assured Jonathan that his family would not be eradicated when David replaced Saul as king. Amen. The formation of this covenant and the parties involved abiding by its term, it showed covenantal loyal love is on display, as Jonathan and David had good intentions for one another. Amen. Hallelujah. Mighty God be praised. My listener, we have a covenant relationship with God through his son, Christ Jesus. And we have a covenant relationship with each other. We should have good intention toward each other. Let us seek the benefit of our brothers and sisters in Christ and endeavor not to harm them through our words and actions. Radioland, I cannot help but stress, Let us seek the benefit of our brothers and sisters in Christ and endeavor not to harm them through our words and our actions. Mighty God be praised. Radio Land, this area right here, that's a sermon within itself. Those who are of God, they love the body of Christ. They care for the body of Christ. Their intentions to the body of Christ are always good intentions. Mighty God be praised. Hallelujah. As life can be demanding, and having friends who share our faith, like David and Jonathan, provides a support structure during critical times. They understand the power of God's words, the importance of prayer, and the strength that is found in unity. When we were to look at Galatians, the 6th chapter and the 2nd verse, what does it express? Carry each other's burdens, and in this way, you will fulfill the law of Christ. Amen. Faith-positioned friends are highly likely to bear your burdens with you and assist you with godly counsel. Our friendships that are firmly implanted in faith are a powerful witness to the world. When those living in the world see the love, genuine care, and unity within our faith-positioned friendships, they are drawn to the monument of Christ's love. Hallelujah. Jesus expressed in John the 13th chapter and the 35th verse, by this everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. Amen. Jesus said that love would be the identifying mark of his disciple. Amen. And Radio Land, love is the identifying mark of the Christian. Mighty God be praised. Amen. Jesus called his disciples friends. If you do whatever I command you, his disciples were his friends because they were obedient, though not perfectly so. Amen. Friendship with Jesus cannot be disconnected from obedience to his commands. Amen. Abstinence from evil is a great part of righteousness, but it is not enough for friendship, says one theologian. Amen. I have called you friends, for all things that I heard from my Father, I have made known to you. Jesus' disciples were his friends because Jesus did not keep secrets from them, but openly revealed what he had received from God the Father. Amen. Another theologian expressed, the friend is a confidant who shares the knowledge of his superior purpose and voluntarily adapts it as his own. Mighty God be praised. Hallelujah. Jesus' disciples experienced his friendship and a concentrated love in its fullness. Amen. The disciples were his friends because he chose them. The disciples were his friends because he gave himself to them. The disciples were his friends because his Father gave them to him. The disciples were his friends because he would soon purchase purchased them. Amen. The disciples were his friends because he conquered them. And the disciples were his friends because they yielded themselves to him. Amen. Jesus loved his disciples, his friends, to the end. A love that never ends. Hallelujah. A love that reaches to the fullest extent. A love that has no limits. Mighty God be praised. May we love our friends like Jesus to the uttermost in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Like I said a few weeks ago, when the world saw the disciples' ministry, they also saw the ministry of Jesus Christ. When the world see our ministry and see our friendship, may they also see Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Radio Land, life's evening sun is sinking low. A few more days, and I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, where there will be no setting sun. My Lord, the only life that will endure is one that's kind and good and pure. And so for God, I'll take my stand. Each day I'll lend a helping hand. Life's evening sun is sinking low. A few more days, and I must go to meet the deeds that I have done, where there will be no setting sun. Mighty God be praised. When we were to look at the second part of Peter, the third chapter in the eighth verse, it expresses, but do not overlook this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord, one day is 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day to God. My listener, God's perception of time is infinite and eternal, and his sense of time is not limited by the same constraints as ours. Let our friendships reign in God in the mighty name of Jesus. Let our friendships reign in God. Why? Because Jesus is the greatest friend. Jesus is the true friend. He laid his life down for us. Oh, glory be to God on high. He laid his life down for the world. The Sanhedrin Council, what did they do? They turned on him and they tried, my Lord and Master, with no one to defend. Within the halls of Pilate, he stood without a friend. The world may turn against him. Allah love him to the end, and while on earth I'm living, my Lord shall have a friend. To all who needs a savior, my friend I'll recommend, because he brought salvation. That's why, mighty God be praised, I am his friend. I'll be a friend to Jesus. My life for him I'll spend. I'll be a friend to Jesus, until my years shall end. Radio Land, I say to you this afternoon, Jesus is your friend. He is your friend. Be a friend to him this afternoon. There's no friend on planet Earth like him. A friend who loves every day in the same manner, in the same way. Mighty God be praised. Accept him today as your Lord and your personal savior, and I can guarantee you, you will never be disappointed. You will never be disappointed in Jesus' name. God richly bless you. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Amen. Radio Land, I quickly say, humbly and constantly. We need to remind ourselves that except the Lord build the house, the labor in vain that built it. Is your life controlled by the triune God? Has sin crept into your life and clogged the channel of fellowship, communion, and intimacy with the Father? Do not allow sin to hinder your relationship with the Father. Turn to Jesus today for cleansing and yield your life without reserve to his Lordship. I say to you, if you wish to accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, do say this prayer after me. Father, I admit that I am a sinner. Forgive me for all of my sins. I accept that your Son, Christ Jesus, is the Savior of the world, who died, who was buried, and you rose him from the dead on the third day for my justification and for my righteousness. Prescribe my name in the Lamb's Book of Life, and may I daily take up my cross and follow after you. Thank you for my salvation. In Jesus' name, amen. For those of you who have prayed this prayer in Radio Land, you are now a believer of Christ Jesus. It is most important that you find a Bible-believing church where you will grow, become mature, and be a disciple of the Lord. Welcome to the family of God. In Jesus' name, amen. Radio Land, do let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of friendship that is built on the foundation of Christ Jesus through faith in you. May our friendships bring honor and glory to you always, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. May our friendships be used as a witness to your love and grace, and as a source of strength, encouragement, and support for the journey ahead, in the mighty name of Jesus, the Most High God, the great hearer of prayer, the Most High God, the great answerer to prayer. Thank you for answered prayers, in Jesus' name, amen. Radio Land, it's been an absolute joy spending the most quality, sacred, holy, and divine time with you in the presence of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, with myriads and myriads and myriads and myriads of angels who are on assignment. Radio Land, be blessed, be encouraged, have a beautiful and a blessed weekend. In Christ Jesus, amen. Greetings to you, Evangelist Lauren. It is well, it is well. I give God thanks for our friendship. 29 long years in the mighty name of Jesus. Hip, 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 hooray! Hip, 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 hooray! Mighty God be praised, in Jesus' name. Radio Land, loving you all with the love of the Lord. May the Lord bless you and keep you. Kindly once again, do share the broadcast for the propagation again of God's gospel around the world. We want God's gospel and his kingdom to multiply, expand, increase, populate, proliferate. Hey, glory be to God, and expand in the mighty name of Jesus. From myself, Pastor Karen, Pastor Terrence, and Pastor Orlean, God bless you all in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Y'all ready to go up or no? Anybody ready? Come on.
Heavenly Father, I ask that you seal the broadcast in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Surely goodness and mercy may it follow us all the days of our life, and may we dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. In Jesus' name, amen.